Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to start your seeds for a hydroponic system, or pretty much anything else too. I feel like most videos overcomplicate this process, so I'm going to get right into it. Here's what you need. You need an enclosed space where you can crank up the humidity for your seeds. You can find these standard at pretty much any garden center, and then I just found this tray separately, and I use it to hold my growing medium, but you don't need it. Now that brings us to growing mediums. Now this can be seed starting mix, starter pucks, growing pods, coco core, vermiculite, rock wool, you name it. Today, we're using growing pods and they look like this to hold our seeds. The reason I'm using growing pods is because I'm gonna chuck these right into a hydroponic system immediately after they sprout. You also need a grow light, and a heat mat is totally optional, but it really helps the process speed up. Again, you can find these at any garden center. You just have to look around and you can probably find a kit with all of this stuff together. You're also going to need tweezers and slash or a pencil. Tweezers are really nice if you have tiny little seeds that are tough to grab by hand, but by all means, you could do it by hand. A pencil really just helps you poke a hole where you want to put the seed into. So if you already have pre-established holes like I do in my growing pods, you don't really need this. You also obviously need seeds. I've got hot peppers here, but I'm gonna be growing baby spinach in my pods. And lastly, I have a spray bottle here because I just need some sort of water source to dampen my pods. I'm going to make sure all my pods are moist but not wet, and then I'm gonna pop them all into a slot in my greenhouse. You do not want your pods dripping, just moist. Use your tweezers or alternatively a pencil to place your seeds into your growing medium. Not all of your seeds are going to germinate. It's just a fact. If you're growing some leafy greens like cilantro, you can slot a couple seeds into each pod and it won't matter if both sprout because they'll probably grow up all right. If you're growing something thicker like bok choy, you might want to just take your chances with one seed because it'll be bad news bears if both seeds germinate and the roots get all wrapped up. Next, put on your heat mat 24/7 and your light onto a 12 to 18 hour timer. Or you can just do that manually. I'm going to be using the Felix Smart Controller for this. So Felix actually lets me remotely control my different systems, so I can just set up a timer directly through that. I can also look at my air temperature and humidity, and that's what this little sensor in there is doing, so I'm gonna get a really good reading throughout this entire process. And that's it. If you notice your humidity is low, you can add a bit of water to the base of the tray, but you don't wanna overwater. So now you're essentially just watching for mold and you should be all good. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to drop a like on it and leave some feedback down below.